Assalamu alaikum, how are you students? I am here with another virtual class of physics. In today's class, I am with you, Rizwana Mukhtar, lecturer, Department of Physics, Milestone College. Students, you have already learned that our third chapter of second paper book is going on, that is current electricity. And in my today's class, I am going to discuss about a very interesting topic of this chapter, which is Wheatstone Bridge. I hope you will be with me and it will help you for your better study at home. So, let's start our today's class. Dear students, our today's topic of discussion is Wheatstone Bridge. You can see the diagram of a Wheatstone Bridge on the board. In this diagram, you can easily identify that there are four resistance P, Q, S, R are connecting in a series combination as they are connecting one by one. And as the connection of these four resistance, they create a loop. We can say that A, B, C, D, A. By connecting these four resistance in series combination, a loop is created. And in this loop, there are four junction points. A, B, C and D. We can consider these four as a junction point. And in the opposite two junction point, A and C, these two junction points are opposite. So, in these two opposite junction points, there is a cell connected and other two opposite points, B and D, other two opposite junction points, there is a galvanometer is connected. And that type of formation of circuit is known as the Wheatstone Bridge. So, students, if you have to write the definition of Wheatstone Bridge, then how you can write it? You can say that if four junctions are made by the formation of a loop by four resistance in series combination and if there is a cell connected between the two opposite junction point and a galvanometer is connected to the opposite two junction point, then thus the circuit is made is called Wheatstone Bridge. Now, why we are calling it as a bridge? Actually, this galvanometer, which connecting the opposite junction of this loop is considered as the bridge. Okay, so that's why this circuit is known as the Wheatstone Bridge. And here you can see, you all know that current is flow from the positive terminal of a cell, and here current I is coming at the first junction point and this current will divide into two parts, that is I1 and I2. Now after that, when I1 current which reach at point B, here three things can happen. Know that current always flow from high potential to low potential. So when this I1 current will go through IG, when we consider that the potential of B point is larger than the potential of D point, that is, if we consider that VB is greater than VD, in this case, this I1 current will divide into two parts. That means some portion of I1 will go through Q resistance and some portion will go through the galvanometer. So, in that case, we can say that I3 is equal to I1 minus IG, as some portion of I1 current is divided or go through the galvanometer. Now this I3 current will come at point C, and what will happen with this I2 current? When this I2 current will come at point D, in the same time this current IG will also come at that point, and as a result this I2 and IG current combinedly will flow from this S resistance. So we can say that I4 is equal to I2 plus IG. Now when this I4 and I3 current will come at point C, you can say that IG and IG will cancel. That means there will be the I current will come to the negative terminal. That is, the amount of current which starts from the positive terminal will be same when it comes at negative terminal. Now, just think the opposite. That means if The potential difference of B point is smaller than D point, or if the potential of D point is greater than B point, then what will happen? Now if we consider that the potential of D point is greater than potential of B point, in that case what will happen? In that case, when this current I2 will come at point D, then this current will divide into two parts. That means some portion of I2 will go through IG. Now the direction of current will change. Now this current will flow from D to B, but in previous the current was flowing from B to D. Just remember it, okay? So now we can consider that from I4, that is the value of I4 will be I2 minus IG, as some portion of current I2 is going through the galvanometer. And so we can write that in case of I3, here the same thing will happen, that is this current IG will come at point B and I1 is also come at point B, and after this combined current will go through the and after that these two combined current will go through this Q resistance. So we can write that I3 is equal to I1 plus IG, and when this I4 and I3 will come at C point, in this case there is also I current will flow from negative terminal. Okay, students, now consider that the potential of point B and point D are same, that is VB is equal to VD. Now what will happen? You know that when there is no potential difference between the two end of a resistance, then there will be no flow of current. So in that case, when I1 current will come to the point B, then the total current, this I1, will go through the resistance Q. That means I3 will be equal to I1. And in the similar way, when I2 will come at point D, as there is no potential difference, so total I2 current will flow through resistance S and they will come at point C, and after that the I amount of current will come to the negative terminal of the cell. So students, when these two terminals have same potential, in that case this Wheatstone bridge is considered as the equilibrium position. Okay, so I am going to derive the condition that in which condition this Wheatstone bridge will be in equilibrium position. So dear students, now I am going to derive the condition of equilibrium position for a Wheatstone bridge. But before that, just consider that the potential of point B is larger than the potential of point D. So in that case, you know that when current I1 is come to point B, then that current will divide into two parts. That is, some portion of I1 will go through this galvanometer and some portion will go through the I3 point. And students, here one more thing you have always remembered, that the resistance which are used in Wheatstone bridge, the sequence of this resistance will always be same. That means P, Q, R, S. That is, the first arm is P, second arm is Q, third arm is R, and fourth is S. Always remember that. First, second, third, fourth. P, Q, R, S. Never break this condition. Okay, never break this sequence. That is, all time we have to consider first arm of a Wheatstone bridge is P, second arm is Q, third arm is R, and fourth arm is S. Okay, so whenever we are going to solve this math, then in that case you have to remember it very clearly. Now here you can see that B is a junction point. So at this point, firstly I am going to apply the Kirchhoff's first law at point B. So we can write that applying Kirchhoff's first law at point B. Here you can see that I1 current is coming at point B and the direction of Ig and I3 is just opposite. So we can write that I1 is positive and as I3 and Ig current are going through this point, so we can write that minus I3 minus Ig is equal to 0. And now make it as equation 1. In the same way, we can apply Kirchhoff's first law at D point. Okay, so again applying at point D. So in point D you can say that this I2 current and Ig current are coming at point D and I4 current is going through point D. So we can consider that I2 and Ig are positive and I4 is negative. So we can write that I2 plus Ig minus I4 is equal to 0. Made it as equation 2. Dear students, now I am going to apply Kirchhoff's second law in A, B, D, A loop. Okay, so applying Kirchhoff's So students, when we apply Kirchhoff's second law in A, B, D, A loop, then we can say that as I am considering that I am going through A, B and the flow of current or the direction of current is also A, B. So the product of I and P will be positive. So we can write that I1 P. Now, I'm going through BD and the current is also going through this BD line. So we can write that IG plus IG into G. Here G is the resistance of galvanometer. Now consider the DA line. Here I'm going through DA, but the flow of current is given here AD. So this will be the negative. Now I can write that minus I2R is equal to, as you know that in Kirchhoff's law we consider that the product of current and resistance is equal to the total electromotive force, but in this loop there is no cell is connected, so we can write that this is equal to 0 and made it as equation number 3. In the similar way, now I am going to apply Kirchhoff's second law in B, C, D, B, C, D, B loop, B, C, D, B loop. We can write that B, C, that means the direction of current and the loop we consider is similar. So this is positive I3Q. CD, the direction of current is just opposite the loop which I consider, that is it will be the negative value. So we have to write minus I4S. Now DA, here is also the opposite direction, so this is again negative. So we can write that minus IG into G is equal to 0. Now make it as equation 4. Now, as we are solving the equilibrium position for Wheatstone bridge, and you know that equilibrium position means the potential of point B and point D is equal. That means when these two points have the same potential, then this Wheatstone bridge will be in equilibrium position. And you know when दिस टू पॉइंट विल हैव द सेम पोटेंशियल देन दैट देयर विल बी नो करेंट पास थ्रू गैल्वेनोमीटर. सो इन दैट केस वी कैन कंसीडर दैट IG इज इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ वी कैन से दैट एट इक्विलिब्रियम पोजिशन IG इक्वल टू जीरो. That is, there will be no flow of current through the galvanometer. Okay, so from equation 1, we can write that from equation 1, if we put the value of IG is 0, then we will get I1 minus I3 is equal to 0, or I1 is equal to I3. We can consider it at equation 5. In the same way, from equation 2, if we put the value of IG 0 in equation 2, then we can write that I2 minus IG, sorry, I2 minus I4 is equal to 0, so that I2 is equal to I4. We can consider it at equation 6. Again, if we apply this same condition in 3, then we can get that as the value of IG is 0, so this total portion will be 0. Then we can write that from equation 3, we can write that I1P minus I2R is equal to 0, or I1P is equal to I2R, or we can write that I1 by I2 is equal to R divided by P, and we can consider it as equation 7. Now, again, we are going to apply the same thing, that is, if we consider that IG is 0, so from equation 4, we will get, for equation 4, we will get I3Q minus I4S is equal to 0, or I3Q is equal to I4S, or I3 by I4 is equal to S by Q. Now, students, from equation 5 and 6, you can see that I1, I3 is equal to I1 and I4 is equal to I2. So, if we put these two values here, then we can write that I1 by I2 is equal to S divided by Q. So, made it as equation 8. Now, you can see that in equation 7 and 8, here the left side is same. So, we can write that R by P is equal to S by Q. So, from seven and eight, we can write that R by P by Q, or if we simplify it, or if we simplify it, then we can write that P by Q is equal to R by S, equal to R by S, and this is the condition of equilibrium position for a Wheatstone bridge. I am going to solve two mathematical examples by using this condition. I hope it will be more clear to you than how we can apply this formula in math. Dear students, now I am going to solve two mathematical examples by using Wheatstone bridge principle. Our first question is that you can see that there is a diagram of Wheatstone bridge, and the given informations are that is the value of P is 4 ohm, Q is 8 ohm, S 16 ohm and R is 12 ohm. Now the question is, what amount of resistance is to be connected in the fourth arm so that the bridge becomes equilibrium? That means you can see that they give all information. That means the resistance of first, second, third and fourth arm, four arms resistance is given. But as they ask you that how much or how amount of resistance is to be connected in the fourth arm so that the bridge will be in equilibrium position, that means this bridge is not in equilibrium position. Okay, so here the given informations are resistance of first arm. You know that first arm means P. So the value of P is given here 4 ohm. Resistance of second arm. Second arm is Q and the value of Q is given here 8 ohm. Third arm means R and the value of R is given here 12 ohm and S is given here 16 ohm. As we have to determine the value of S again, so I am considered it as S 1. Now from the condition of Wheatstone bridge equilibrium position, we can write that we know P divided by Q is equal to R by S. So we can write that S is equal to R Q by P. Now the value of R is 12, value of Q is 8 and the value of P is 4. So we will get the value of S is 24 ohm. Okay, here 4, 12 into 2, 24 ohm. Now you can see that the value of S is 24 ohm. That means if we want to make this bridge at equilibrium position, then we have to add 24 ohm resistance in fourth arm. But the given resistance is 16 ohm. So you can see that the value of S is larger than the given value, that is S1. So we can write that as S is greater than S1. That is, we have to increase the value of resistance in fourth arm. And you know that if you want to increase the resistance, then we have to add resistance in series combination. That means if we add few resistance in series combination with the fourth arm, then this bridge will be in equilibrium position. So how much resistance we have to use? Now we can calculate it, that as S is larger than S1, so S2 resistance connect in series combination then this bridge will be equilibrium. So we can write that S is equal to S1 plus S2. Now we know that S2 is equal to S minus S1. The value of S is 24 and the value of S1 is 16. So we can write that is equal to 8 ohm. That is, if we add 8 ohm resistance in series combination with fourth arm of this Wheatstone bridge, then this bridge will be in equilibrium position. Students, our second question is 6 ohm, 18 ohm, 10 ohm and 60 ohm resistors are connected in the forearm of a Wheatstone bridge. What value of resistance and how it should be connect to the fourth arm of the bridge so that equilibrium is obtained? That means this question is also similar with the previous one. Okay, now and here they also ask that in fourth arm, that means in S, what amount of resistance we have to connect to build that bridge in equilibrium position. That means the given informations are such that that bridge is not in equilibrium position. So the given informations are resistance of first arm, that is the value of P is given here 6 ohm. Second arm, that is Q, is given here 18 ohm. Third arm, R is equal to 10 ohm. And the value of S is given here 60 ohm. As we have to consider the value of fourth arm, that how much resistance we have to connect in the fourth arm, so I am considering it as S1. Okay, now we know that P by Q is equal to R by S, that is S is equal to R into Q divided by P. Now the value of R is 10 and the value of Q is 18 and the value of P is given here 6. So we will get the value of S is 30 ohm. Now students, you can see that the value of S is 30 ohm and the given information is they connect it with 60 ohm, that the given resistance is larger than the required resistance. This is the required resistance. That is, if we want to make this bridge in equilibrium position, so we have to decrease the value of the given resistance. And you know that if we connect resistance in parallel combination, then the value of resistance will be decreased. So we can say that as S is less than S1, so if we add S2 resistance, in parallel combination, then this bridge will be equilibrium. So now we can write that 1 by S is equal to 1 by S1 plus 1 by S2. 1 divided by the value of S is 30 minus 1 by S1, the value of S1 is 60. So after calculating it, you will get the value of S2 is 60 ohm. Means if we add 60 ohm resistance in parallel combination with the fourth arm of this Wheatstone bridge, then that bridge will be in equilibrium condition. I hope you have understood it. So students, that's all for today. Thank you for being with me. Stay home, stay safe.